along with some very unpredictable weather, the Texas spring brings some beautiful wildflowers, including
those Texas blue bonnets, how sweetly they grow.
And in 1997, the Texas legislature declared Ennis the home of the official Bluebonnet Trail. Ashley Kalunga of the Ennis Convention and Visitors Bureau says this year the posies are popping up early.
We keep saying that April is our busy season, but we had visitors coming in probably starting about 2 weeks ago, if not 3 weeks ago.
Judith was visiting from North Carolina to see the bluebonnets and buy some seeds to try to grow them herself.
I've had him get 5,000 of them.
Jenna Rokas of the Ennis Bluebonnet Trails said they update the trail maps daily.
We take a lot of pride in driving the trails ahead of time to have the best viewing for the visitors. So when they come into the Visitors Bureau, and we're open 7 days a week, they will get a trail map.
And if you'd like to blaze the trails yourself,
there's an app for that.
And how Texas is this? Ennis, y'all, is an app, and it has an interactive GPS map that you can follow the trails, and that has been really popular. We are very excited about how many people have downloaded Ennis, y'all.
Judith will take a little piece of Texas bluebonnet love home with her to North Carolina.
It's really a beautiful thing what y'all do here with the bluebonnets and the Indian paint. We want to say thank you for the flowers.
The bluebonnet trails run through April the 30th, but the festival is next weekend.
On Saturday, April 8th, the Quaby Sisters, it's a nationally acclaimed bluegrass band, will be performing downtown.
Every which way I look, I see your face before me.
Bluegrass and bluebonnets is Texas as you can get, so we're very excited about that.
A link to the bluebonnet capital of Texas, Ennis, can be found at krld.com/aroundtown. I'm J.D. Ryan, News Radio 1080 KRLD.